Hello there, my name's Suze Shardlow. I'm the Developer Community Manager here at Redis. Thanks so much for joining us today. And thanks for joining us for all of DevCember. It is nearly over. It's going to be over soon, but don't worry, we've got loads more content for you. So stay tuned for that. If you are new to DevCember or you just want a little bit of a memory refresh of what's going on, go to developer.redis.com/DevCember. Try not to make your fat fingers or your muscle memory type of DEVcember. It's DEVcember, developer.redis.com/DEVcember. You'll be able to see all the topics we've covered so far and a link to all the videos for those topics. So what we are doing is Monday to Friday between the 1st and the 24th of DEVcember inclusive. We're doing a little 15 to 20 minute taster of various Redis data structures, product features. We've got some brand new products as well that we've been showing you all, just to give you a little bit of a taster, a little bit of an intro into Redis, or if you're already a seasoned Redis user, to give you a little reminder of things that you might not have used recently. And for me, I recently took RU 101, Introduction to Redis Data Structures, which is one of our Redis University courses, which you can find at university.redis.com. And I found this a really good refresher for me as well. A little bit of supplementary info, because obviously RU 101 only covers, it covers quite a number of basic concepts, but doesn't cover everything you need to know. So this has been really good for me on a personal level. You can sign up for RU 101 or any of our 8 Redis University courses at any time. You've got a maximum of 6 weeks to do them. But, you know, if you're clever, like my colleague, Justin, who's going to be joining us shortly, you do them all in a few days. You can sign up for them at any time, and you've got a maximum of 6 weeks to finish them. So please do check that out. So yesterday we looked at not crossing the streams with Simon. And that was a really fun gig. And also yesterday, outside of DEVcember, we had our regular Redis monthly live with folks from my team, developer relations team here at Redis, talking about the new Redis clients. And there's going to be some more client stuff coming up this week. We've already covered 3 of the clients. So we've covered JavaScript, Python, and .NET so far in DEVcember. If you go to our DEVcember page, you'll be able to find the videos for those. And then we've got Java coming up later this week. So as for today, we're going to be looking at what the deal is with PubSub. Now, PubSub is something that was covered in RU 101, but it's always good to get a little refresher of that. And today I'm welcoming back my good friend and colleague, Justin Castilla. So let's bring Justin into the mix. Hi, Justin.
Hello, how are you doing?
I'm very good, thanks. How are you?
Good. I feel like I haven't been here in a couple days.
I feel like I haven't seen you for weeks. Yeah. So I watched Redis Monthly Live last night, enjoyed it. I was like, wow, I haven't seen that man for ages. And the good thing is, today is the shortest day of the year in the Northern Hemisphere.
Woohoo!
Yeah. So in a few weeks, when we're doing these things at this time of the day, it's not going to be pitch black here. So I'm happy about that.
Can't wait to wake up when it's light outside.
I know. It's really horrible when you wake up in the dark and then, like, you finish work in the dark. It's not good, is it? Mm-mm. So, yeah, that will change very soon. But yeah, as for now, you're going to tell us what the deal is with PubSub, so I'm going to hand over to you.
Awesome. Thank you. So when I first heard PubSub, I was so excited. I'm like, oh, we're going to a bar and having a delicious sandwich. It's not like that, really. But that's okay. So PubSub, a very, very short sentence is somebody's sending a message and then somebody else is listening for a message. And that's it. So now let's actually go into the details. I have slides provided. There we go. So there are 3 main components to conceptualize PubSub messaging. There's a publisher, which can be a client that is just sending out messages. It could be a sensor, an IoT, like a temperature, humidity, pressure, air quality, like a weight trigger sensor, anything like that. It's a source of data that pushes data into a channel. Publishers have no knowledge or control over who consumes their data from the channel. Okay, so I'll use that as an example later. Now, what's a channel? A channel is a specified destination a publisher chooses to send data to. subscribers receive data from channels. Now, channels aren't exactly data structures that we manipulate. We just send data into a channel. Lastly, we have subscribers. A subscriber receives messages from one or more specified channels. So that kind of makes sense, but think of it this way. I came up with this actually this morning, which I thought was very appropriate. Every morning, I feed my two cats, Bird and Basil. I open up a tin of wet cat food, and I dip a scoop into their dry kibble, and these make two specific noises. Now, when I'm opening that tin, it's just making a noise. It's not directional. It's not, you know, I'm not ringing a bell for the cats. It just makes a noise. But the cats who hear that noise, they go crazy and they run into the kitchen and start rubbing their heads against my legs and getting really excited for food. So basically, my publisher is my tin of cat food that's being opened and making a noise. And it's pushing to a channel, you know, cat food noise. And then the cats, they subscribe to that sound, that channel. So whenever they hear it, they take actions. So sometimes I'll open a tin of tuna fish or chicken or chili or tomatoes or whatever. The cats will be like, it's lunchtime. It's early. They're subscribing to that sound, but it's not meant for them. Because my chili is for me, not for the cats. So just another way of thinking about it. So let's actually look at this in practice. Let's say we have a subscriber. And this could be anything. It could be a client, Node.js. It could be a front end, anything like that. But basically what's happening is we're calling on Redis, subscribe, and then a key, temperature colon 94606. So let's say temperature colon 94606 is the local sensor for my zip code where I live in Oakland. So basically, any data that's sent to that channel, this subscriber is going to receive. So now, here we go. It's listening to that channel. The channel doesn't actually have to exist. That key doesn't even have to exist yet. The subscriber is just sort of sitting there waiting for information to go into that channel. So now we have a publisher. Now you'll see the publisher here is calling the Redis command publish to the key temperature colon 94606, and then it's giving a message or a value. And a value can be a string. And in this case, it's 48 for 48 degrees Fahrenheit. So the publisher is sending data into the channel. And since the subscriber is subscribing to that channel, they receive that information. Publisher never knows who it's sending data to. They don't care. It doesn't matter. One or a million different subscribers. It just sends it to the channel. And that makes it very easy. You don't have to have a chain of recognition or knowledge of who's going to what. So you can actually get a little interesting of this. We could have two different channels, two different publishers publishing two different things, and two different subscribers. So the top we have our temperature channel. So our subscriber on top is receiving the temperature. Now on the bottom, we have a publisher that looks like they're posting to a humidity key, humidity colon 94606. And it's posting the message of 0.7. That's going through the channel, and the subscriber on the bottom left is receiving that data of 0.7 because they subscribe to that channel. Now we can get a little bit more interesting here. Let's say we have one publisher who's pushing to two different channels. That's not a problem at all. You have one single client that's taking two different measurements, temperature and humidity, and they're publishing to two separate channels. So you see this one single publisher who's publishing two different channels is reaching two different subscribers. And another different model is two publishers pushing to two different channels and one subscriber is actually subscribed to both channels. Now we have two publishers on the right. They're both publishing to, one's publishing to temperature 94606. Another one is publishing to humidity 94606. They're going through the proper channels. Now you'll see on the subscriber on the left, it's a P subscribe and then asterisk 94606. That is a pattern subscribe. So they're subscribed not to a specific channel, but to a specific pattern. So anything, any key that contains 94606 or a zip code in the United States in Oakland is going to receive that data. And so that allows you to get all information from all channels with that 94606. And that's pretty cool. And we can actually do that in practice. So here I have my lovely web of open Redis CLI, command line interfaces. You can have multiple panes or windows in Redis Insight just yet. So we're going to use it locally. So let's see here. We have a subscribe. And let's say this one is subscribing to temperature : 94606. And there we go. So we can see that it is subscribing to this key. It's received that message. Now, on another terminal, and this could be another, you know, client somewhere else across the world. It doesn't matter. This could be a weather station down the street or on top of the hill next to me. I will publish. You'll see it's asking for another channel in the message. I will publish temperature : 94606. And then we'll put in the current temperature, which looks like it is 43 degrees. Yikes. Let's make it 43.5 because the sun is coming out. So watch both windows. Okay. So this right here, I just published one message. My subscriber who subscribed to temperature :94606 received that. So 43.5. So this is me publishing and another subscriber subscribing to my message. So let's create, let's go down to this one and let's call subscribe humidity :94606. There we go. And then up here, I'll do publish humidity :94606. Oh, sorry. Should put a humidity amount. Let's call it 0.0. It's 0.65. It's a little dry. Let's actually make it 0.43. Okay. So now you see the bottom terminal here that only subscribes to the humidity channel is affected, not the one up here, because this one up here, it's only listening for the temperature channel. So now down here, let's do P subscribe. And the pattern now is what it's asking for. Let's do asterisk 94606. Now it's listening for all messages or all channels that contain 94606. And you can look at our command reference for publish and subscribe, and you can see the different patterns that it will accept. It's its own separate little, you know, sub. It's almost like, you know, we'll see the pattern. Let's see here. So let's do publish temperature. Let's actually go up back up here. I'm going to publish the temperature. And so we should see, there we go, two separate terminals receiving that information. And you can see here, two people are listening. So one right here that's subscribing to temperature :94606, and one here that's subscribing to 94606. Now let's do this again. Let's do humidity. All right. So now the one that originally subscribed to humidity is receiving that message because it's humidity 94606. And this one right here is listening to anything with 94606. So it's also received the humidity 94606. So it's very, very handy when you have separate different entities listening for different topics, perhaps within the channel. And let's do just to make sure everything is nicely rounded out, let's do AQI, which is the air quality index in 94606. And it's not the best outside. It's a little hazy. We haven't really had a whole lot of rain in a couple of days. So let's say it's 123. Not good, not great. So a little thought experiment. I'm pushing AQI 94606. I'm publishing it. Is this one, or this one going to receive it, or all three, or a combination? Let's find out. Okay. So the one that's listening to just any key that has 94606, that is the one that's listening. Well, it's actually capturing this because, again, this one up here, specifically only temperature 94606. The one on the bottom left is specifically listening to only humidity 94606. And the one on the bottom right is listening to anything that has 94606 in it. And you can do a couple different things. You can do a couple different options that we can actually look up. So it's here, publish. And I think there's help. I forget which one it is. But yeah, publish is a really cool feature. PubSub is a really cool feature. And it's a very classic design paradigm of message sending and receiving, and streams also it has superseded it, but it is also extremely important to know about PubSub as you're going along and working on your different projects. So this one is a really good for taking temperature sensor readings, as you see here. While California was having a lot of wildfires, I was looking at our purpleair.com website, which is a it's like an elective air quality mapping system where people would buy little modules that would connect to their internet and actually push and publish their air quality and temperature readings to a server somewhere. And you could actually go and you can find extremely localized air quality sensors. That was really, really interesting. And I actually bought a air quality tester. It would sniff the air around my house and actually give out a reading for my local area 94606. So that's just another example of, you know, PubSub in action. In our previous RU101 live course that I did with Suze, we actually used an airline as an example. So once an airplane comes into, you know, an airport, there's a lot of different things that need to happen. We need to reflect that the airplane has landed on the departure and arrival board on that screen. So that's a publish and a subscribe. We need to alert the gate, a plane's coming. So the plane publishes that message. The gate subscribes to that channel and says, oh, we have a plane coming. Also, we need to figure out where the baggage claim is going. So they're going to subscribe to that information. So one plane publishing an information, all these different aspects and facets of an airport is subscribing, and they're receiving that and they're doing their job based off of what plane is going on. So cool. That's PubSub. As always, please check out the command reference for PubSub. It's actually quite interesting. There's also a really great write-up on PubSub within the Redis IO page. And as always, I'm here to answer any questions. If you have any questions, please go to our Redis Discord. And thank you very much. Go ahead and take it away, Suze.
Thanks, Justin. And well done for keeping that to 15 minutes. I don't know how you do it, honestly, but perfecto. Well done. Thank you. And I really love the examples that you use in your demos. It really brings it to life, and it just makes it so much easier to visualize what's going on when you're using examples that people have seen before, or they can relate to, or they can imagine using themselves. Because, you know, anyone who's had a pet knows full well what it's like in the morning. Like, I used to have two cats, and they knew what the sound of the cat food just scraping against the side of the container sounded like. Oh, yeah. You just had to move it like 1 millimeter. And you mentioned, like, you didn't have to ring a bell, but in their brain, it was like ringing that bell.
It's like a loud horn, yeah.
Yeah, and they were super fast. And yeah, now I remember that plane example as well, because, you know, you don't just have to subscribe to like one of two. You could have like countless different services there that you want to subscribe to. And like an airport is a really good example, because like you say, when a plane lands, there's all different things like the baggage claim, the departure board, you have to get immigration ready, all of that good stuff. So yeah. And I also really love how you demonstrate that with all the different windows as well. It's really cool to see when you're publishing it and then your subscription comes through.
Yeah.
It's really cool. So yeah, thanks so much.
It's a lot of fun. Thank you. Yeah, the first thing I did when I learned about PubSub is like, well, I want to see this in action on my computer. And so, yeah, you have to make that the wacky grid of terminals, but it's totally worth it. And just thinking out loud, just thinking, if you subscribe to our YouTube channel, you know, quick little plug, when we release a video, we will broadcast. Oh, thank you. We'll broadcast that information. We don't know every single one of our subscribers, but we'll make sure that we broadcast that to our channel, and our subscribers will actually get that notification that we have published a new video. So pub subs everywhere.
Yeah, especially now where people, you can subscribe to almost anything. You can get a reminder for almost anything. Like even if you're just setting an alarm on your phone, you know, you're essentially subscribing to something there, aren't you?
Yeah.
So all of our lives are all automated now. And, you know, this is one of the fundamental things that's powering all of that. So, yes. And like you said, that is covered in RU 101. Mm-hmm. Introduction to Redis data structures. So any folks out there who want to learn a bit more about PubSub and also how it connects up with all the other different data structures as well, highly recommend that course. We live streamed it and the videos are still up on YouTube. So if anyone wants to go have a look at them, and the course is 6 weeks long. I took it in about 5 weeks because we were doing the live stream, but it only took you about 3 days, didn't it?
Well, you know, I had to ramp up real quick.
Yeah, true. Yeah, there was that pressure because you were onboarding as well. But just to kind of let people know that, you know, you don't have to commit 6 weeks of your life to do this. You can take it as slow, as fast as you want to. So, yeah, thanks again, Justin. You're going to be back on Thursday, aren't you?
Yes, we're going to be talking about geospatial, which is a lot of fun. And I'm going to find some really cool location names and interesting biomes that we can use. So look forward to that.
Yeah, cool. And I'm looking forward to that as well, because I still really love your geospatial video that you made, like the proper produced one, which is also featured in RU1 at 101 as well. RU101 is a really good course. I think everyone should do it. I keep plugging it, but like everyone should have done it by now. I don't know.
Absolutely. What's going on. No, it's a good starter.
Yeah, definitely. Right, cool. Thanks for joining me today, Justin. I will see you later in the week.
Alrighty. So
Justin's coming back. No worries. Thank you. Justin's coming back later in the week. But yeah, between later in the week and now, there's still some more content coming. So tomorrow, I have got my good friend and colleague, all of my colleagues on my team are my good friends and colleagues. My good friend and colleague, Brian Sam Bowden, who we have not yet seen on DevCember. But if you were watching closely yesterday at Redis Monthly Live, you would have seen Mr. Sam Bowden on there. So Brian Sam Bowden is going to be talking about the Redis client that he has recently written and launched for Java developers. So I mentioned earlier that we have 4 new clients and we've covered 3 of them already so far. So Simon Prickett covered the Python one. Guy Royce covered the one for JavaScript developers, and Steve Lorello covered the one for .NET people. Brian Sam Bowden is coming to join us tomorrow to talk about Redis OHM for Java developers. So we're going to be springing into Redis OHM with Brian tomorrow. If between now and then you want to catch up in any of our videos, please go to developer.redis.com/DevCember. You'll find all the videos on there. And also don't forget about our weekend challenges. So our weekend is on Saturday and Sunday. We don't work Saturdays and Sundays, so we won't be doing live stream on those days. But instead, we put a little challenge for you on GitHub, just a very gentle one. There's no competition involved. But if you want to do that and submit a pull request, we are very happy to look at that. There are 3 of them up there so far. Just take your pick of whichever of those 3 you want to do. There's no time limit. So please do have a look at that. And we would really love to know what you think of these streams as well. So please do leave us a comment. And like Justin said, if you ever want to chat to any of us, we are here Monday to Friday on Discord. We are all over the world here. So Justin, as you could probably tell from the accent, is in California and I am in London, England. So we're already covering quite a number of hours between us there. So if you want to chat to us on Discord, please join us there and we would be happy to talk all things Redis with you. So we are going to be back tomorrow at approximately the same time. So in my evening here in London, England, and in the morning in California, we're going to be back around 5 o'clock-ish tomorrow with Brian Sam Bowden. And until then, look after yourself and stay safe. See you later. Bye.